And with his body comfort, no anxieties at all. Next. And we want to go to the highest one. Let's go look at Vrindavan. Next. You can go fast now. This is a picture of Ram that we did. And this is on the wall of Prabhupada's temple in Boston in 1968 or 1969. And I came in late to the temple. And just to show how merciful Prabhupada is, I came in late because I was having a fight with my husband. And he went in on time, but I was too angry. So I came in late, and the devotees were already walking on the basement. Kirtan had already been finished. The devotees were walking on the basement. Prabhupada was saying the Jaya Bhani prayers, like Radha Dasi was saying my Jaya Sisha Guru Gurana, Jaya Vishnu Prabhupada. And then the devotees all set up again, and that's when I walked in the back door. And then Prabhupada called for me, and he could have said, I know where he's been, fighting with your husband and doing my own common sense clarification, but he didn't do that. He called out to me across the whole, all the assembly, the assembly, and he pointed to this painting, and he said, "Will you do this painting?" And I said, "Yes," and he said, "You are already in Vaikuntha." Just to show, you know, loving care. Okay. And this is Krishna in Goloka Vrindavan calling us with his flute. And very interesting, this picture is in Bhagavad Gita. And interestingly enough, Prabhupada writes in the Chaitanya Charitamrita that Krishna's flute playing, by which he's calling the gopis, and then the gopis come out of their homes and they're in the middle of cooking for their families, and they're in the middle of putting on makeup, they have eye shadow, eyeliner on and one eye. And then Krishna plays his flute, and they are still in a hurry to leave everything that they put on their necklace on the, around their waist, and they don't put their makeup on the other eye, and they stop cooking, and the things start burning, and they're feeding their husband, they just walk out right in the middle of it. So this same flute playing that attracts the gopis, and by which the author of Chaitanya Charitamrita says, may this flute playing benedict you all so that you can participate one day or one lifetime in the Radha Lila. May this flute playing benedict you. And then Prabhupada writes in the purport that the Chaitanya Charitamrita is about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is combined Radha and Krishna. And included in his being is the whole Radha Lila. So the Chaitanya Charitamrita is not different from Krishna's flute playing. So if you study the Chaitanya Charitamrita, then gradually, according to Amy's questions, that's one way to get from here, where we are now, to where we want to be. Okay. Not only Chaitanya Charitamrita, but all of us. I'm sure if you would all want to come even every day and just sit with Radha Bhakti in the form bar and just read some different books, they'd be happy to do that. Of course, they can't make a good proof for every day in their life, but I'm sure if you want to read every day, that would be really good. And here's some more. Just quick ones. The story of Dhruva Maharaj. Story of different demigods. Story of Prithu Maharaj, great king, very just and great king. The four Kumaras, little boys who, they were four of the first sons. They were the first four sons of Brahma, who we saw before was the creator of the universe. And he wanted them to get married, the procreate of the universe, but they were just very cute, and they just remained as five-year-old boys, so they wouldn't have to develop all these desires that gave us so much pain. Or Shiva and Parvati. I think because it's just a few minutes left. Well, maybe we should go to the 3-day one because it's another time we go to this. But we'll go to the 3-day one because that has music and it kind of like speaks for itself. Thank you.
Can you paint my car?
Yeah, the state of Clinch painting that's up here, that's the result of what he's saying, can you paint my heart? And when he gave so many instructions at the painting was developing.
Now, which mantra are you with, or which book are you with?
They just have that version, but this one here on this side is very angry. This is, I'm sorry, this is Rati Mandri, which is Rupa Mandri, on the ceiling side. And this is Vinod Mandri. And this Mandri here is generically called Guru Rupa Mandri. Generic because that's not her name, but you can see her Guru as that Mandri. Guru Rupa means the Guru and his form is a Mandri.
And a new painting?
And Brita is home of it, and here this is our lady's name. This is one we have seen before. That is one of the sort of binding Krishna to work. Yeah. And this is a cover of a new book that's going to be published in a couple of months. So Bhakti Vinod Thakur getting a vision of Sri 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 and Sri 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 his own explanation, not in Lalita. This man that was known as Lalita, rather than his most intimate friend in Krishna Lila. And he's called Shikhanda's most intimate associate in Shikhanda Lila. So he's explaining to Bhakti Vinod Thakur his own explanation of the first verse of the Bhagavatam. And he's giving Bhakti Vinod Thakur an inspiration to explain many other verses of the Bhagavatam. Which became the book that we're looking at tomorrow. Which Gurudev lectured on in 2 years in a row in Badger. And if any of you can come to Badger in June this year, it's totally transformational. Now what you're going to see is how this different, how a few of the paintings developed from the sketch stage. It's so very quickly. This is the downhill one. Starting from that sketch like that and the sketch to that, being more clear. And the sketches are only about like 2 inches big. That one's about 6 inches big. 6-7 inches big. And the color sketch and the paint. And this one, did you give it to the writers after you?
No.
We're going to be making a presentation to her and this fumble, this painting. This is how the painting started.
Okay.
Is it really? So she's Radhadas and this is called Radha alone. This is the color sketch. And I'll come to the painting.
One
more. And one last one, this is called Jayashree. Jai means the picture, so Radha Rani really victorious over Krishna. So here Krishna is, you can see the line drawing, the color sketch there, and the early line drawings are just a few inches thick, and here's the big painting. We'll have posters of these in the corner.
No.
We have them here too. So Krishna knew that Radharani would be going to the bank of the Yamuna to get silver pots, so he just, quote unquote, just happens to be there. And he's saying to her in the same Jayashree, oh, I see you have 2 heavy pots, can I help you with one? And Radharani says, no, thank you, you're a deboshi, and I'm a place in every verse, so don't talk to me. Just do it and please do it even more. Now I'll ask if there's any questions or comments. Please come to the end.
Okay, so Leonard said that to the grid edge, we can, it's like an expansion of all around the connection group, right? So, how can we also understand if people are going to go?
That's a very good question. I'll repeat the question. We read in the scriptures that the spiritual master is a manifestation.